The ancient Maya civilization was incredibly rich and complex, leaving behind a legacy of advanced knowledge and fascinating cultural practices. Here are some unusual and intriguing facts about their lives. Advanced calendar system. The ancient Maya civilization, known for its advanced understanding of mathematics and astronomy, developed one of the most intricate and accurate calendar systems in the ancient world. The Mayan calendar system consisted of three main calendars: the Tzolk'in, the Hab, and the Long Count. The Tzolk'in is often referred to as the sacred round, or the divine calendar. It consisted of 260 days, combining a cycle of 29 days with another cycle of 13 numbers. This resulted in a cycle where each day had a unique combination of a number and a name, which would not repeat until all 260 combinations had been used. This calendar had a significant religious and ceremonial importance, and was used to determine auspicious days for events like ceremonies or battles. The Hab was a 365-day solar calendar composed of 18 months of 20 days each, followed by a 5-day period known as Wayb, which was considered an unlucky time. The Hab was primarily used for agricultural purposes, as it aligned closely with the solar year and the agricultural cycle. However, because it didn't account for the extra quarter day in the solar year, as our current Gregorian calendar does with leap years, it would slowly drift out of alignment with the seasons. The Long Count calendar was used to record historical dates and was designed to keep track of longer periods of time. It was based on a count of days since a mythical creation date that corresponds to August 11, 3114 BC in the Gregorian calendar. Dates in the Long Count are often accompanied by corresponding dates in the Tzolk'in and the Hab. These three calendars work together to create a system that could pinpoint any date in the past or future with remarkable precision. The Maya used this complex calendar system for everything from agricultural planning to historical record-keeping and prophecy. The end of a 13-baktan cycle in the Long Count calendar, approximately 5,125 solar years, was often associated with significant events or changes, which led to the popular but misguided belief that the Maya predicted the end of the world in December 2012. Astronomical knowledge. The ancient Maya were accomplished astronomers, and their observations and calculations of celestial bodies were remarkably precise. Astronomy was deeply intertwined with their cosmology, religion, and daily life, influencing their architecture, agriculture, and calendar systems. The Maya tracked the movements of the Sun, the Moon, Venus, and other visible planets. They also recognized and cataloged constellations. Venus had particular significance for them, and they associated it with warfare. They were able to predict lunar and solar eclipses, viewing these events as significant omens. Many Mayan buildings and cities were constructed to align with celestial events. For instance, the El Castillo Pyramid at Chichen Itza has 91 steps on each of its four sides, adding up to 364, plus the top platform equals 365, the number of days in a solar year. Additionally, on the spring and autumn equinoxes, the setting sun creates a shadow on the pyramid that looks like a serpent descending its stairs. The Maya recorded their astronomical knowledge in codices, books made from bark paper. The Dresden Codex, one of the few surviving Mayan codices, contains extensive tables for predicting lunar and solar eclipses and the cycles of Venus and Mars. The concept of zero, crucial in mathematical calculations, was used by the Maya, and this greatly enhanced their ability to calculate astronomical phenomena accurately. Their advanced astronomical knowledge allowed the Maya to develop an intricate understanding of the cosmos and its influence on earthly events. Their astronomical and mathematical systems remain a testament to their intellectual and cultural achievements. Writing system. The ancient Maya developed one of the few fully developed writing systems in the pre-Columbian Americas, known as Maya script or Maya glyphs. This complex system combined elements of both logographic and syllabic writing. In a logographic system, a glyph or symbol represents a word or a morpheme, a meaningful linguistic unit. Many Mayan glyphs represented whole words. In a syllabic system, symbols represent syllables. The Maya script had a set of glyphs representing syllables, which could be combined to spell out words phonetically. Mayan texts were usually written in double columns of glyph blocks, read from left to right and top to bottom in pairs. Each glyph block contained one or more glyphs, with main signs and various subsidiary signs. The Mayan script was used to inscribe stone monuments, pottery, bark paper books, codices, and other materials. It was employed to record historical events, astronomical observations, calendrical information, and religious texts. After the Spanish conquest, the use of the Mayan script declined and knowledge of how to read it was lost. It wasn't until the mid-20th century that significant progress was made in deciphering the script. Today, while not all Mayan texts can be fully read, a substantial portion of the script has been deciphered, revealing a wealth of information about Mayan history, society, and culture. The Maya script is the only Mesoamerican writing system that has substantially been deciphered, and it represents one of the most sophisticated writing systems in the pre-Columbian New World. Advanced agriculture. The ancient Maya were adept farmers who developed a variety of advanced agricultural techniques to sustain their population despite the challenges of their tropical environment. Here are some of the agricultural practices they used. This was a common technique, also known as shifting cultivation or milpa farming. The Maya would clear a piece of land by cutting down and burning off the vegetation. The ash from the burn would fertilize the soil and crops would be planted in this enriched land. After a few seasons, when the soil's fertility had declined, the plot would be left fallow to regenerate while cultivation moved to a new plot. In hilly or mountainous areas, the Maya built terraces to create flat areas for farming. These terraces reduced soil erosion and improved water retention, making it possible to farm in areas that might otherwise have been unsuitable for agriculture. In low-lying, swampy areas, the Maya built raised fields with canals in between. These canals provided a source of water for irrigation, and the rich organic muck that collected in them could be scooped out to fertilize the fields. The Maya practiced a form of agroforestry, where they cultivated a mix of crops and trees together. This not only maximized the use of space but also improved soil fertility and provided a habitat for beneficial insects and birds. The Maya rotated crops to help maintain soil fertility and reduce the risk of pest infestations. They also practiced polyculture, growing several different types of crops together in the same plot, which can improve soil health and crop yield. The primary crop of the Maya was maize, corn, which had significant cultural and religious significance. They also cultivated beans, squash, chili peppers, queso, cotton, and a variety of fruits. Although rain was usually sufficient for crop growth, the Maya also developed irrigation systems for periods of drought. These advanced agricultural techniques allowed the Maya to sustain large populations and sophisticated city-states for centuries. Beekeeping. The ancient Maya were skilled beekeepers, and their expertise in this area is a fascinating aspect of their culture. They practiced a unique form of beekeeping with stingless bees, Meliponibichai, which are native to Central America. The Meliponibichai, also known as the royal lady bee, was the primary species kept by the Maya. These stingless bees are smaller than the common honeybee and produce a unique, highly prized honey. The Maya housed their bees in hollowed-out logs or in specially designed ceramic pots. The ends of the log or pot would be sealed with removable caps, allowing the beekeeper access to the hive. Mayan beekeepers would capture wild colonies of stingless bees and relocate them to their hives. They would manage the hives to optimize honey production, a process of splitting colonies and providing supplementary feeding. Bees and honey had significant cultural and religious importance in Mayan society. The Maya had a bee god, Amusin Cab, and honey was used in religious offerings and medicinal treatments. The Madrid Codex, one of the surviving pre-Columbian Maya books, contains a section on beekeeping rituals. Mayan honey was used not only as a sweetener in food but also for its medicinal properties, and it was a valuable trade commodity. The Maya also fermented honey with the bark from the bauchi tree to create a ceremonial mead-like drink, also called bauchi. Traditional Mayan beekeeping techniques are still practiced today in some parts of the Yucatan Peninsula. However, the stingless Melipona bee is now endangered due to deforestation and the introduction of Africanized honeybees.